Hello, YouTube and fellow DC comic fans. I'm Keith OneShot, and today is Wednesday, February 28th, and you know what that means? It is New Comic Book Day. So I'm going to quickly go over and show you the new comic books that I got today, and the ones that I recommend you pick up as well. We are going to start this off with a brand new series, a brand new number one, fresh from the pages of DC Metal. This is The Terrifics, which features a team of Mr. Terrific, Plastic Man, Metamorpho, and Linya Wazoo, which I do not know much about, but I do like the rest of the team. I'm a big Mr. Terrific fan. He's very smart. He's all about fair play. So let's see what this comic has in store for us and if The Terrifics is going to be worth picking up as it comes out. Let's see what The Terrifics have in store for us. All right, the next comic book is also one of the new Age of Superhero DC comic post-metal characters. This is Silencer number 2. Silencer is a former assassin who tried to leave that life behind. She used to work with Leviathan under Talia al Ghul, which is a subset of the League of Assassins, League of Shadows, whatever you want to call it. And she left that life behind and is now being dragged back into it. I'm not 100% sure after the first issue if this series is for me, but I figured I'd pick up the second issue, give it a chance, and see what it has in store for us. All right, so that is Silencer number 2. The next book I got is another brand new number 1, and I believe this is her first single run. This is Mara, Queen of Atlantis, number 1, The Battle for the Throne begins here. They've been pushing Mara a lot for the last few years, and I think it's a great idea, as it's another strong DC woman character who's very powerful, and she's been underrated for years, and I'm glad to see Mara finally getting some spotlight and some shine. So this is great, and I had to pick up her number 1. This is Mara, Queen of Atlantis, and I hope that it's a great book. Alright, the next book that I got, this is it's a side story. This is part 2 of 6. This is Raven, Daughter of Darkness. And like I said, it's a side story. It takes place in the same universe. And this is the same Raven that we know from the current DC Rebirth Teen Titans lineup. And this is just her story, which is really good. And I enjoyed the first issue. And I can't wait to see what's in store for us in issue number 2 without spoiling too much from the first issue. So just read it if you like Raven. If you like Raven, you'll probably like this. Okay, I also got Teen Titans number 17, which obviously also has Raven in it too. And this is mostly a Beast Boy story, as I'm pretty sure. I skimmed the pages, but I haven't read it yet. And this is going to be post, the Titans of Tomorrow arc that they did, which was really badass. Okay, so that is Teen Titans number 17. Pick it up if you like the Teen Titans. The next story that I got is Batman Beyond, issue number 17 as well, which has Terry McGinnis, Bruce Wayne, I believe, and a bat in the background. And this arc, I believe, is called Payback Part 4, The Long Payback Part 4. And just to give you something that I've been waiting for years, and I can't wait, it doesn't happen in this issue, but it's gonna happen. I've been saying this for years since they invented Terry McGinnis and Matt McGinnis and Batman Beyond. I want to see Robin Beyond, and they've been hinting it at us for a while now, and I can't wait to see that happen with Matt McGinnis, who's technically Bruce's son as well. All right, so the next story that I got, I can't wait to read this book. I love Action Comics. It's been really great lately. This is the conclusion of the Booster Shot storyline. This is Action Comics number 998. We are getting very, very close to Action 1000 being written by Bendis. It's going to be great. Can't wait to read that book. Action 1000 is going to be a milestone in comic book history in general, and especially for Superman. So this is the conclusion of Booster Shot. There'll probably be one or two more fluff individual stories, and then Action 1000, as Bendis will be starting his run after that. And I think he's getting regular Superman as well. Either way, Action 998. The next book that I got, this is easily my favorite story. I love The Flash. The Flash has been killing it all of DC Rebirth. And Wally West just took the mantle back over as The Flash. He has been The Flash since he came back into Rebirth. But Barry lost his powers at the end of Perfect Storm part 3? Yeah, so in part 2, he lost his powers. I am doing that story on my dramatic reading series. I am currently doing, which is going to be uploaded later on today, Flash Annual. That's an amazing Wally West story as well. Wally West is going to be taking the mantle, I think, which I can't wait to see. He's on the cover. I love this story. Flash is one of my favorite books. Joshua Williamson is an amazing writer, and Howard Porter is an amazing artist, which he's not actually on this book. This is a different artist. This is Carlos De Anda with the art, so it's going to be a different art, but I do love Howard Porter. I love his art, and I do love Joshua Williamson, and I love The Flash. All right, the last book that I got is Detective Comics number 975. In the last issue of Detective, there's been the ongoing arc with Clayface turning into a monster again. Batwoman got a gun from her father, and she eventually used it on Clayface, and that killed him. It made it so he couldn't form his body again, and the clay ended up dead clay. What is her name? Dr. October, Victoria October, said, yeah, it's just a pile of clay now. Clayface is dead, and that's sad to see. But this is the trial of Batwoman, because Batwoman has kind of been shunned. Orphan ripped off her bat signal, which symbol, off of her chest, which was amazing. And it was a really powerful moment in the last issue of Detective. And then her father came up to her, Batwoman's father came up to her, and put a different symbol on her suit and said, "Are you ready for a new type of mission?" I love Detective. Flash and Detective are the two best stories in all of DC Rebirth so far. I mean, you got your medals, and you got your Doomsday Clocks, and you got all your other great stories as well. But every issue of Detective and Flash, I have loved since the Rebirth era. I love it. I mean, I loved it before that as well, but it's been killing it in the Rebirth era as well. So this is the last comic book that I got this week. I'm Keith One Shot. Take care, have a great day, and goodbye!